Blessed are the pure in heart, they have learned the angels' art. While on earth in heaven to be, God by sense on sin to see, cleanse from sins offensive stain, fellowship with him they gain. Nearness, likeness to the Lord, their exceeding great reward. Worshiping in spirit now, in his inner court they bow. Bow before the brightening veil, God's own radiance through it all. Serious, simple, of intent, teachably intelligent, wrap they search the written word till his very voice is heard. In creation him they own, made him in its arms alone. Most amidst his Sabbath calm, morning light and evening balm, him they see through labor life, trusting pain and care and strife. This light class O noontide, temper not conceal his rays. Hallowed does their every breath, dying they shall not see death. With the Lord in paradise, till like his diabol this rise. Nearer than the seraphim, in their flesh I sing see him. With the Father in the Son, through the Spirit ever one. Amen. Video 58, Solution 14, Scanning and Closing the African Jewish Christian Deficiency Gap. A spiritual mapping or the ethnic scanning of all the races in the world is necessary to identify their Jewish or Jewish Christian status. Let us examine the status of Africa in terms of its Jewish Christian composition, beginning with the Christian dominated West African nations. And countries such as Liberia, Sierra Leone, Togo, Benin Republic, Ghana, and Southern Nigeria. Among them, we see an African, Canaanite, Egyptian, or Ethiopian, or Cushite consciousness. They have not fully entered into the Christian consciousness, or those who possess the Christian consciousness have altogether been marginalized by the political system and have not been allowed to contribute their quota by the African Canaanites. We also have the Muslim-dominated West African countries such as Gambia, Senegal, Niger, Chad, Mali, Northern Cameroon, and Northern Nigeria. The consciousness here is still Cushite, Egyptian, and Canaanite. They have not entered into Arab consciousness and have not produced leaders like Muammar Gaddafi, Gamal Abdel Nasser, or Saddam Hussein. East African and Southern African nations, though Christian dominated, have not entered into the Christian consciousness, or at least politically. Their pan-Africanist thinkers and leaders are influenced by anti-Christian, anti-Jew, and anti-Semitic narratives and models. Their dream is about the ancient Egyptian civilization and its religion. In Nigeria, Yoruba nationalists and Pan-Africanists talk about a return to the local gods such as Ogun, Sango, Oya, Oromiyo, etc., and so on and so forth. The Igbo revolutionaries used their Arochukwu god of Chukwu Okeke Abiama to fan the embers of Igbo nationalism. In Kenya, Ghana, and other parts of Africa, they talk about how Europeans had the land, and Europeans have the Bible, and how the Europeans gave us the Bible and took our land. This is the narrative that influenced Pan-Africanism in Kenya, Ghana, and other parts of Africa. In South Africa, the ANC, the African National Congress, like other similar anti-apartheid parties, are anti-Semitic, and they demonize Europeans up to today. They demonize the Jews while downplaying the culpability and blameworthiness of African leaders and their own people. African thought is like a wayward child, when he became backward later in life, begins to blame the witchcraft of his stepmother for his backwardness. African thought does not want to take responsibility for their own backwardness. They push the blame at European colonialism, whereas Chinese and Indians have faced similar colonialism. In Africa, some talk, like Julius Malema of South Africa, of the Economic Freedom Party, they talk about the United States of Africa. Their dream, or the dream, is similar to that of the Syrian, Iraqi, and Libyan-backed Socialist Party. In a nutshell, or in summary, African Pan-Africanist thought is anti-Christian, anti-Jew, and anti-Semitic. Early Ethiopian Jews and Christians did not proselytize Africa. They did not evangelize Africa. Ethiopian Jews speak Amharic rather than Hebrew. Majority of Africans came in contact with Christianity through European missionaries rather than through Ethiopian missionaries, which made many unbelievers to be saying that Christianity was or is a white man's religion. The Jewish composition of many African people and races is the lowest in the world. The crowns of some Negroid monarchs, African monarchs, resembles that of an Egyptian pharaoh. Traditional African religions is the third fastest growing religion in the world after Christianity and Islam and other Asian religions. In Latin America and the Caribbean, there are countless adherents of Yoruba deities. The Hausas, Fulanis, Kanuris, Soninkes, Shua Arabs, Tutsis, Maasais in West, Central, North, and East Africa are a mix of Ethiopian, Futite, and Canaanite civilization and consciousness, and Shemitic Arab consciousness. The Negroid Southerners in some African states are a mixed hodgepodge of Hamitic, Ethiopian, Egyptian, Canaanite, Moabite, Ammonite, Edomite, and African consciousness and anointing, while their Afroasiatic northerners have an Assyrian, Babylonian, Midianite, Amalekite, and Arab anointing or consciousness. The Igbos of Nigeria and the Ethiopian Falasha Jews have a Hamitic, Canaanite, Egyptian, Ethiopian, and Jewish Christian consciousness. Traditional Canaanite religions is still very strong among them. The political views of the Igbos tend towards a single monoethnic Jewish Christian state, a secular Christian democratic state, or a Jewish and Christian state like Israel. However, their consciousness waver between the normal African Cushite, Egyptian, Canaanite consciousness and Christian Zionist or Jewish Christian consciousness. The spiritual and ethnic mapping of West and Central African states show Hamitic, Egyptian, Ethiopian, Futite, Canaanite, and Afro-Asiatic or Afro-Arab traits. Eastern African states are Egyptian, Canaanite, Futite, Afro-Arab in ethnic composition and consciousness among their northerners, and Egyptian, Canaanite, and Christian among their southerners. Southern African states like South Africa, Botswana, Zambia, Mozambique, Zimbabwe have some Japhetic European, Japhetic, Shemitic, Ashkenazi or European Jewish presence. These are the Europeans and European Jews living in South Africa, Zimbabwe, Namibia, Botswana, Zambia, Lesotho, Mozambique, and so on. Also in South Africa, there are Shemitic races and nations like the Indians and the Chinese living with the majority Black African, Egyptian, Cushite, and Canaanite Africans. North African and Islamic states like Mauritania, Algeria, Morocco, Tunisia, Egypt have Shemitic Arab, Shemitic Jewish, Hamitic Berber, and Hamitic Egyptian, Coptic, Nubian, and Canaanite presence and consciousness. That is, the Arabs are the majority, and the African Berbers and African Egyptians, the Copts, descendants of the ancient Egyptians, are the minorities, and the minority Berbers living among the majority Arabs in North Africa. Asian Arab Islamic states like Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, Gulf, Yemen, and so on and so forth, have Shemitic Arabs as the majority, and a minority Shemitic Jewish presence, and minority Hamitic Africans that can be described as Hamitic Egyptian Kushite or Egyptian or Ethiopian presence. Islamic Iran have Shemitic Persian majority. The Iranians are the descendants of the ancient Persians who conquered the Babylonians. So Islamic Iran is Shemitic Persian majority, followed by Shemitic Arab minority, Shemitic Jew minority, and Hamitic Egyptian Canaanite African minority. Asian Mongoloid states like China, Japan, South Korea, North Korea, Vietnam, Taiwan, Hong Kong, Vietnam, and so on have Shemitic Mongoloid Asians, people with the slanting eyelids as majority, then Shemitic Jews as minority. Arab and non-Arab Islamic states like Syria, Iran, Turkey, Iraq have Shemitic Kurds, Armenians, and Shemitic Jews living among them as minorities. India, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Burma, Malaysia. These are basically people of the Indian race, the Shemitic Indian race, and they may have a minority Arab or minority Africans, dark-skinned people, or minority Jews. Indonesia too, I think Indonesia, Malaysia, they're a mix of Indian and Chinese people, Shemitic people. India has a minority Muslims, but of the Indian race in Kashmir. Then China has the Uyghurs, who are Muslims as minority. So all this in Sri Lanka, Nepal, Burma, Malaysia, Indonesia have a mix of Chinese and Indian people, both Shemitic people. And they all have dark skinned people who are a blend of Asian and African people. There are dark skinned Hindus that look like black Africans. China has Shemitic Uyghurs and Turkish people. Let's go to Europe now. European states have Japhetic European as their majority. Europeans people, descendants of Japheth. Then they have European Jews who have intermarried with Europeans. It can be described as a Japhetic Shemitic Ashkenazi Jews. Then Shemitic Shepardic Jews, a mix of Asian and European Jews. Then Shemitic Asians, that is Asians who are living in, let's say, Russia and some other European states, and the Black Americans, the Black Britons, and so on, Black people in France. This can be described as a Hamitic European, Egyptian, and Canaanite African presence. Russia, as we said, have Shemitic Asian, Chechen, Muslim minority. Germany has the largest concentration of Shemitic Jews or European Jews also. Who are European Jews before the Second World War? Today, USA has the largest concentration of or largest numbers of Jews in the world, followed by Russia. Russia or the former USSR have the largest, second largest number of Jews in the world, while Japan and Asia have the largest number of Jews and Jewish businessmen in Asia. One can theorize, hypothesize, or formulate a law stating that there is a positive correlation between Jewish presence and economic development and prosperity in any society. America is the number one country because it has the largest number of Jews. Russia is the second most powerful country in the world because it has the second largest number of Jews in the world. China is being developed by Jewish American businessmen. So is not South Korea. So one can say that Jewish presence correlates positively with the level of development. North America and South America. North America is USA and Canada. South America is Colombia, Ecuador, Peru, and so on and so forth. There are Japhetic Europeans, English speaking, Spanish speaking, Portuguese people, Japhetic Ashkenazi Jews, that is European Jews, Shemitic Shepardic Jews, Shemitic Indians, and Hamitic Ethiopian, Egyptian, and African Canaanites. That is in, see in South America, for instance, the majority, they are a mix of Spanish, descendants of Spanish people who have intermarried with the local Indians, Shemitic people, and with Africans who are brought there as slaves, the Egyptian Africans. Also, the Caribbean countries like Jamaica and so on, they are a mix of European people and African people. The Europeans are the Japhetic Europeans, and the African people, the Egyptian Canaanite Africans. Australia and New Zealand are Japhetic Europeans, Japhetic Shemitic Jews, and Hamitic Ethiopian Egyptian Aborigines. This is the ethnic and anthropological picture of nations and the root cause of development and underdevelopment among nations and races. What lesson can we learn from here? The lesson is that Africans need to move hurriedly and desperately out of the Jewish Christian deficiency gap and destroy its foundational cause of Egypt, Ethiopia, and Canaan. Africans need to use the Jewish and Christian platforms.